Hi, my name is Michael Pope, and I'm a professor in the Department of Chemical Engineering at the University of Waterloo. I run the 2D Materials and Electrochemistry Lab, which really focuses on 2D materials development. So the most famous 2D material is the Nobel Prize-winning graphene, and graphene is a hexagonal lattice of carbon atoms that's just one atom thick. So it's like a mesh of carbon. So this gives it a lot of unique features, like it has a really high surface area. It's one of the lightest, highest surface area materials known to man. And it has really unique electronic properties, like high mobility. It's essentially in a single layer form. It's almost invisible. It's so thin. So we work with graphene and similar 2D materials like molybdenum disulfide and hexagonal boron nitride and things like this. These are all building blocks that we can use to make different advanced materials, electronic, optoelectronic, and energy storage materials. So we work in my lab on developing improved processing strategies to make these materials at scale. So we try to scale up to, you know, create ton per year quantities in a sort of a cheap way to make this more attractive for commercial industry. We also work with developing methods to process these materials into different composites. So when you take graphene or other 2D materials and you process them into a film, they often restack, and you have to use other materials and interfacial engineering ideas essentially to couple these with polymers and ionic liquids and surfactants to really get the most bang for your buck out of these materials. So that's one way we can make improved energy storage devices, and that's the other thrust in my group. Is we aim to make next generation battery materials and devices called supercapacitors. So we all know lithium ion batteries. They're the workhorse or the heart of our electronic devices these days, and now electric vehicles. But lithium ion batteries are reaching their limits, and what my lab group does is we try to focus on using 2D materials as a tool to create better batteries from materials which have a potentially higher energy density than lithium ion. So like using sulfur, which is very abundant and cheap, as a cathode, or using silicon as an anode. These all have problems like mechanical stability problems and electronic conductivity problems. And when we interface these with 2D materials, we can alleviate these. So we're hoping if we can get the right sort of combination of materials and tools together, we'll really be able to enable much longer lasting batteries that are less expensive and that can reach the market hopefully soon.